Don't touch the water, let alone go in. That's the message from health officials in Martin County tonight. Good evening. I'm Todd McDermott. Thanks for joining us here at 11. Health officials are waiting for lab results right now to determine if portions of the St. Lucie River could be toxic. Angela Rozier joins us live from Martin County. Angela, you talked with a man who believes that water made him sick.
That's right. In fact, that man told me that he's lived around these waters all his life, and nothing like this has ever happened to him before. He's sharing his story with us about the water, not only with us, but also he's posted it on a local website because he wants to get the word out. There's something in the water, and Vincent Grindle says he found out the hard way.
This was all purple and red. It's cleared up pretty good now, but you can still see the scarring here. And then it runs up my arm on the back there.
Grindle says about 3 weeks ago, he and some buddies were hunting when he ended up in one of the canals that leads to the Indian River Lagoon.
I contracted some kind of a virus or something. The doctor said it was called cellulitis.
He believes the infection is from the water. This is what you see at Sandsprit Park in Stewart, bluish green algae. This is also where this woman likes to walk her dog.
It's really interfering with the use of the park by all the public.
This man has seen the algae, not only here, but also in other parts of the St. Lucie River.
Saw this huge scum line. I mean, it was like 8 feet wide, just running out, just foamy scum.
Health officials collected nearly a dozen samples Monday and sent it to a lab. They say it's okay to go boating, but people should not touch the water because it might be toxic.
If people get the water in their mouth, it could cause vomiting and diarrhea. If they get it on their skin, it could cause skin rashes and other irritation.
Grindle says he's still on medication for the infection, but he's not going to let what happened to him stop him from enjoying the water.
I was actually upset. I was more upset at the fact that I've grown up here and this water's been around me my whole life. To know that this kind of damage is being done to our environment and the waters that I've been fishing since I was a kid.
Now, the swimming portion of the triathlon scheduled for this weekend at East Island Park in Stewart has been moved to Jensen Beach because of health concerns. Officials hope to have those results from the tests by the end of the week. Reporting live in Martin County, Angela Rozier, WPBF 25 News.